Hello, in this video we are going to see the employee online marketing app. First we have to download the employee online marketing app from the Play Store of BigTables. Now when you open, you have the options for the employee for check-in, check-out, new customers add-on, then product addition, card payment, expenses, inquiry, etc. So this login will be created by the administrator. That admin login, other details will be explained in later video. So the check-in is nothing but when the employee is going to meet a particular customer, so he have to enter that I am meeting this customer and say mentioned okay. So what is the purpose he is meeting the customer, whether it's for demo purpose or anything. These details will be provided in the admin software itself. The list will be created based on their requirement. So what are the lists they are creating in the admin software will be recorded here. Now once the meeting has been over, now he is coming out of the place and it's coming as successful. So successful meet and make a checkout. So this record will be inserted in the particular employee's name. Now once he complete, he has to take some orders. So that orders can be taken in the product. Once he make the order, once he click the particular product section, the customer can be selected from the list. So this customer list will be taken automatically from the PIN code. So the current PIN code, for example, a particular employee is in the PIN code of Trichur or any other district. So at the particular district, there will be PIN code. So that PIN code location will be tracked and the surrounding customers will be listed here. So all customers, there will be 300 to 400 customers, for example. But only few customers will be listed here based on the particular PIN code. That particular employee name will be listed here. So for example, Shivam Traders is an employee. He clicks OK. So once he click, what happens is the list of products will be listed here. What are the products which is added in the admin software will be listed here. The categories. So what are categories we have added will be listed here. For example, grocery items are there. That grocery items we have listed there. Click on that and take order. So once you order, 50 grams, the options, the grams option, everything can be mentioned in the admin software itself. It's going to be customizable. So 50 or 5 quantity, for example, 250 grams. Okay, now this has been done. Comments, anything about this, any additional comments can be given. Otherwise, you can mention nil. So add to cart. Now the order has been added. Now other than this, if you want to add any other details, like for example, oil is there, you want to take an oil. So 1 liter, he needs 10. Say okay. If you want to mention any comments on this particular product, and click add to cart. Now these two products have been added to the cart. Once you come out, you can see the cart option here. That cart details will be, so for Shivam Traders, the Shivam Traders has ordered Bengal gram and sesame oil. If you want to edit any particular product also, you can delete it or you can place order. Now order will be placed successfully. So if in the particular PIN code, if he is meeting any new customers, that customer name can be added here. The name, contact person, mobile number, phone number, address, email can be added here. Automatically the particular current PIN code of the company name will be added in the admin's software. So the administrator can see the new customer details which has been added by the employee here. The company name, for example, is ABC Traders. So he belongs to this particular PIN code, contact person name, and in the mobile number and phone number if it is required, and address. So the address can be added here, and email ID. Now the details has been added. I click OK. Now the customer has been added in this particular location. The customer is added successfully right now. Next comes, if you want to see those details also, you can see in the customer list. So this customer name Prite is been added in the customer list. When the particular employee move on to a new location, this customer list won't be appearing there because that set of customers of that particular PIN code will be listed there. So this is okay. Now if you want to receive any payment from the customer, so he's receiving any payment from a particular customer, so Shivam Traders, for he's paying for any amount for his bill number 25, something like that. So he is receiving payment. At the same time, if the employee is incurring any expenses like travel expenses for that, so the comments can be provided, travel to any district. So he saved this. Once it done, so payment has been completed and expense has been completed. Now if he is incurring any new inquiry from the customer is asking any, so Preete, for example, he is asking, do you have any product like related to, for example, stainless steel items? For example, so the connection was disconnected in my mobile. So I'm again coming to this section. So now the customer is inquiring for a new product. For example, he's asking for a stainless steel. Since the employee will be moving to many places, so he may not remember all the inquiries for many customer. So instead of that, we can have this option for inquiry, a new inquiry received from the customer, stainless steel for example, and he can take a pic image. So for reference, he can take a pic image. So this is all about the app. Now we can move on to the admin software. This is the admin software. So what are the orders being taken by the particular employee will be listed out here. So the order section, there is an order section. What are orders taken by the employee will be listed here. So when the customer wants to, the admin wants to see the orders received by the employee, he can go to the inventory option and click the orders section. So the orders list which is taken by the particular employee will be listed here. So you can see the order number, the trader name, then the mobile number, the delivery details, all the details will be listed here, and the what are the products they have requested will be listed here automatically. You can take a printout also. Now this is in the pending state, and when you ship the particular order, you can take yes, and the bill copy will be generated automatically. So before doing this, so this is a example copy of the bill. Product name, subtotal, tax amount, shipping cost, all those details will be listed here. Okay, so this is the order details. So what I told in the app section, the details like unit of measurement, product, all the products can be added here. So for example, I'll show you this. The grocery items. So what category it belongs to, the grocery, this can be added in the group master. Then the product code, the product name, the description of the product, and the picture of the product, and the cost based on the quantity, it can be added here. So this is the one. Next comes the discount master. So in case if you want to impose any discount for a particular product for a few period of details, so that can be also added for example Horlicks. So that is that has an offer for from and to date. So automatically when the customer wants to make an order, that is the employee wants to make an order, that he can incur the discount. Otherwise he can leave this option, and the list of customers which has been added by the particular employee will be listed out here. This is a customer database, and if you want to, we can search the new employee what we have added. So this is the customer name, Preete ABC Traders, what is added by the employee, and the PIN code automatically will be fetched by the current location of the employee. Next comes the details like expense master, the expense details, the what are the expense the employee can incur can be added here, and track location. So you can track the employee's current location also. For example, you can if you have many employees, you can filter based on a particular employee. His current location, date and time, everything will be listed out here. So this is about a particular employee, or else you have an option of tracking the particular employee here in the reports. You can search for a particular date from so I've logged in on this time. So 4:15 to 5 he was in this location, and 5 to 5 to 15 on this location. So for each 15 minutes you can track the employee's current location, and it will be to start tracking when he makes a login. and attendance details, visit details, everything will be listed over here. His attendance, where he went, check-in, check-out, he checked in on this time, what is his visit details, and any visit details will be listed here. So he has visited this place and number of time he visited, what is the remarks of his visit. Okay, so the order chart, total order chart, everything is listed out here, and order details. So if you want to take a report of a particular for a particular date, that order details will be listed in the order details chart. So for you can search by category wise, so cooking oil, grocery, or product wise, Bengal gram sesame oil, or employee wise. If you want to search for only one employee, so that particular employee, what he has made a order, you can take a printout also. So this is all about the employee tracking, the order getting, and this is the admin side. So the total control can be handled by the particular the administrator. So this is all about the video. Thank you.